Guys, the winner for the previous video's contest was Sri Parmeshwari Harvester Supramani, and he asked me if we modify the winding of a mini DC motor and increase the torque and speed. So that is exactly what I'm going to do in this project, or to be specific, I'm going to try to do in this project. So you can see this power supply, 15 volts, 3 amperes. It's only 15 volts, 3 ampere supply, so you don't feel a thing. Okay, so guys, the question for today is, what will happen if the number of turns per pole on the armature of the motor are not identical? So anyways guys, I searched it a lot on YouTube to see if anyone had conducted a similar experiment, that is converting a 220 volts permanent magnet DC motor to 12 volts DC motor. But since I couldn't find it, so I thought about experimenting it myself to see if it works or not. So let's try it. Note that the experiment is really dangerous, so don't conduct it at home. And guys, I got this permanent magnet motor from a mini blender. Okay, so guys, the motor is completely ready now. Let's see if it can survive the high current
that is going to flow through these springs that are going to feed the brushes. So guys, to power it up, I'm going to use this 12 volts, somewhere around 20 amperes DC supply to run this motor, and there is a great chance that the motor is going to burn out. It is working, but like it is heating up a lot. Super hot. Yeah, actually the current needed is too high, and of course the brushes are not able to feed it to the armature. You see, it is working. All in fumes. The full motor is in fumes. Whoa, the brush is boiling. It's too hot. I think it is going to catch fire. Speed is increasing. I don't know why the speed is increasing. Why is the speed increasing? I don't get it, seriously. Seriously, why the speed is increasing? You can see the speed has, it has gained a lot of speed, yaar. Whoa. Whoa, 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 whoa. Yeah, something bad is going to happen, I'm sure of it. Yeah, the motor is running really fast. Ah, the brush is going cool. It has come to a stop finally. And that brush part has completely melted, guys. You see? It's completely melted. And on this side, motor is like super hot right now. So yeah guys, there is like a few things that we learned from this experiment is that this motor that I used is a 220 volts DC motor, okay, and I converted into a high current DC motor. So like I came from 220 volts to as low as 12 volts, and I gave like a less number of turns, because of which the resistance reduced and the current automatically increased. And then again, I also used 3 times thicker wire, so again the resistance reduced, so it needed more and more high current. And obviously the brushes were not designed to handle that high current, so the result of it was that the motor burned out.